All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Evan Gappelberg, the CEO of NexTech AR Solutions. And Evan, welcome back. Good to see you again.
Thanks. Great to be back, Steve.
So announcement out today that your CFO and a number of your senior managers have all decided to go into the market and purchase stock within the company. And there's obviously been some challenges with the stock going on in the last couple of months. And is this a message to shareholders, to the market? Who are you sending this message to about deciding to buy stock again in the company?
Yeah, I mean, there's a couple of thoughts going on. One is, you know, fear and greed drive what happens in the market. Right now, people are fearful and selling. Our shares in particular are down to the same levels that they were in Q1 of 2020. So it's a significant opportunity, in my opinion, to pick up cheap stock at prices that we haven't seen since Q1 of 2020. So that's almost 2 years ago that the share price was at this level. And back then, if I go back then, we had just come off of our 2019 revenue number, which was 6 million. So in Q1 of 2020, when our stock was $1 US or $1.40 Canadian, we had just done 6 million in revenue. For 2021, here we are almost 2 years later. We're going to end 2021. We've already kind of messaged to the market with about 25 million in revenue, or about 400% more revenue than where we were. And we're positioned for the metaverse, which did not exist in Q1 of 2020. So we're in a better position financially, a better position with our tech stack, a better position with our management team. The leadership is stepping in to buy stock, not just me. I've been a big buyer since day one. All my 10 million plus shares have been purchased in the market or through stock offerings. But if you look at today's news, Andrew Chan, our CFO, is buying shares. Other senior levels of management are buying stock. And I just see our shares as being extremely undervalued. And I think from these levels, I mean, the only reason I'm buying shares, Steve, is because I think they're going up.
Yeah. Evan, is it a case that, you talk about the metaverse, and obviously that became big news in the last couple of months. Is it a fact that people haven't quite caught up to the metaverse yet and that it's coming? Is that a concern that you have, that you need to do almost the job of running the company, but also informing people that this is where technology is going?
To some degree, yes. I mean, I think there are no real small cap metaverse companies that are getting much respect. Mostly it's, the Facebooks, the NVIDIAs, the Unities, the Microsofts of the world. Those companies, you're seeing their market cap skyrocket. And, the small cap companies have not participated in the same way. And I think the reason is that currently we don't have a research report. There's no analyst that's really looking at our tech stack, looking at our company, and putting some kind of valuation on it. On the other side of the spectrum, you have Cathie Wood and a number of other analysts talking about this multi-trillion dollar metaverse opportunity, and they're pointing to all the big cap tech companies. And so I think it's just a matter of time before it trickles down. We're right now, today, Steve, the focus is on the big cap. I think small cap metaverse companies are going to have their day in the sun. And I believe NexTech is going to be one of them.
Okay. And last question, that is, what can people expect for 2022 from the company as far as technology is concerned? And you've made a lot of recent announcements about about technology moving forward. And will that really take shape in 2022?
It absolutely will. It's already taking shape today. In Q4, we're seeing a tremendous amount of business momentum in our 3D and AR product offerings. And if you look at what we have to offer, It really is an expansive technology stack, which includes AR Ties Metaverse Studios, which is a host of product offerings, including spatial mapping, AR Ties 3D, which is where we create our 3D models. That's our 3D model factory. AR Ties Ads, which is the ability to showcase these 3D models as ad units. AR Ties CAD, which is the ability to turn a CAD file, excuse me, into an augmented reality 3D experience. AR Ties Decorator, where you could decorate your room with 3D assets. AR Ties Holograms, formerly HoloX. AR Ties CPG, the genie in the bottle. I mean, I'm just going to keep going. These are our products that we sell, and they all lend itself to the metaverse. AR Ties Labs, which is for education. AR Ties University, AR Ties Events 3D, which is now our event platform, which now is an event metaverse platform because we've integrated our 3D tech into our event platform. AR Ties Portals, AR Ties Concerts, AR Ties Capture, AR Ties Play. So the amount of tech that we've built, Steve, that is applicable to the metaverse is unusual for a small company like ours. I've said it before, I'll say it again, we're very ambitious. We do aspire to be a multi-billion dollar technology company. We think we have the tech to get there. 2022 is going to be the year, I believe, where it all becomes pretty obvious to the market. So
we'll leave it there. Evan, thank you so much. Good to talk to you again, and we'll talk again soon.
Thanks, Steve.
All right, Evan Gappelberg, CEO of NexTech AR Solutions.